contest is a tag team match. In the ring at 241 pounds from Paradise City, wrestling fans, Mike Hart. His tag team partner is from Pensacola, Florida, weighing in at 230 pounds. This is Rick Fargo. Their opponents will be making their way to the ring area, led by their manager, Mr. Gary Hart. First from Sacramento, California, at 250 pounds, Bertolt Basulier. And the world television champion from the land of the rising sun, wrestling fans, this is the Great Moolah.
The JTEX Corporation being represented here with Gary Hart. I did a little research. Found out why Hart has such a close allegiance to the Orientals, Kevin. He's trying to make his money back on an investment he made in Tokyo. He opened a tall man shop in Tokyo, and I heard it didn't do well. But his travels over there took him, you know, he's got a lot of connections. And that's where I heard the Dragon Master. His background is very questionable. But I saw your sanity is questionable.
Well, what's really questionable now is Soya, Muta, the Dragon Master, and Hart's confidence. They're looking, well, maybe I'm wrong. Soya's coming on as offensively as he can. He's taking the bull by the horns. But let me tell you something. This was a surprise here in World Championship Wrestling. When Flair said he was bringing a surprise, he certainly delivered.
Arn Anderson, if he just joined us, has been rejoined, reunited, we should say, with Nature Boy Ric Flair and with Ole Anderson. Indeed, the fans were chanting, four horsemen, in unison. This building was rocking earlier. Wouldn't it be great to see some sort of six-man combat against these guys at Gary Hart? I want to tell you that right now.
Jim Ross, it would be physical. As you say, it would be as physical as you can make it. Ole Anderson, Arn Anderson, and Ric Flair, they make it happen.
Great tag team action here, fans, and more of it this Sunday night at 6:05 on the NWA main event. I hope you'll join us because the Steiners will put the World Tag Team Championships up for grabs against the Samoan SWAT team. The Giant Samoans battle the Steiners for the World Tag Team title this Sunday night at 6:05 on TBS. The Great Muta has yet to be pinned in the NWA. He is a man that will go against Ric Flair, against Sting, and he will wrestle Lex Luger in that round-robin tournament. Remember, points will be awarded for the way that a victory is attained. One fall, 15-minute sudden death time limit event.
Jim, the match that interests me most is Flair and Sting. The one that interests me second has to be Muta and the winner of each one of those matches to me, whether it's Luger beats Muta or Flair beats Sting, whoever wins matches is going to be the winner of those two. Because my change, I predicted that Sting had the momentum going. After today, it's all Flair's better. Flair is the man. To be the man, you have to beat the man.
And that's what Buzz Sawyer is doing right here. He is beating the man. He's beating Mike Hart brutally here on World Championship Wrestling. Still to come, Tommy Wildfire, Rich, and Captain Mike Rotunda. And the total package will have some comments about this Wednesday. And we'll see the U.S. champion in action here on the program. Well, I'll tell you what, next week's program is going to be quite interesting. Teddy Long, we heard his comments before we went to commercial break. Next week, it'll be the Cuban Assassin. And Norman in a bounty match.
Well, I think that Ron has every right. Norman's gotten on the skin. First of all, Norman should be thankful that Teddy invested all his money. Norman should be thankful that Teddy gave him a wrestling job. Norman should be thankful that he isn't at a rocket somewhere and the nuts.
I like to have a thorough accounting of Norman's funds the last few months with Teddy Long. He might want to have an audit. I don't trust Teddy Long.
Okay. Well, I'll tell you what. Teddy bought him a beautiful Cadillac. It's not Teddy Long's fault that Norman doesn't have a license.
Right. So Teddy probably keeps it in his own garage, too, for him, right?
Hey, out of the goodness of his heart, he only charges him $100 a month to do it.
And he lets Norman wipe it whenever Teddy wants.
Hey, did you talk to Norman, huh? What a heck of a guy that
is. I just had a feeling how it works. Mike Hart being brutalized by Buzz Sawyer. Now Muta. Muta with a finesse and the style. Hart and Sawyer with that power. What a combination here.
ceremonial purposes.
He wants the dog to fly. That's what it means exactly.
Belly-to-belly suplex by Mad Dog Bill Sawyer.
Shades of the Steiners. And looks like they say dogs can't fly. We're going to see one fly right now.
This one needs his shot. And Mike Hart needs some medical attention after the beating he has just sustained.
Here are your winners, Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer.
The matchup of Arn Anderson against this Buzz Sawyer is something I'd like to see.
Gary Hart looks to be very calm and collected after what happened earlier. That may be a little facade. I don't know.
Here goes the Mad Dog. He flies and he lands. And you could get this guy up with a shovel because he isn't getting up after that.
Tommy Rich, Captain Mike Rotunda, next on World Championship Wrestling. The Omni box office as well. I'm exasperated today.
I am too. That surprise deflated.
Excuse me, but I'm going to tell you something, Ricky Flair. A wise man once said, if you have a surprise, you unveil it at the right moment. The right moment would have been Starrcade, but you are a fool, and you will pay. You believe that he is going to make a difference. Do you believe that J-Tex is going to blow it all because the Four Horsemen are back? I'm telling you, Starrcade, future shock. There is going to be a shock belt far stronger and far greater than anything this wrestling alliance has ever conceived, because Arn Anderson will be short and sweet.
Fans, don't forget to join us tomorrow night, 6:05, for the main event, the Steiners and the Samoans. Tomorrow night, 6:05, for the world title. Let's get out of here.